that mind, it certainly exists. Sometimes it drives you blind and makes you surprised. Sometimes it makes you smile, sometimes it makes you so wise. The world just seems to hide, it's up to you now.
Easy enough. Thanks, man.
What is going on, my reptile junkies? Guys, it's Sunday. Oh, I feel 10 times better today than last night. Really appreciate all the contest entries once again. Hope y'all enjoyed that. I wanted to put a lot more into that video, guys, but
for sure.
I wanted to get it out there, and it was like 3 o'clock this morning before I finally got to go to bed.
We were so tired.
I went ahead and made some video clips last night of unboxing the Goliath and the Rattlesnake, because I just could not stand the thought of them staying in those little Tupperwares all night long till today. So sit back, check that out. We're going to go to that first. It's the unboxing of those two, and then we'll come back and talk about it a little more. I think it's about 7 or 8 minutes long, so hope y'all enjoy it, and we'll pick right back up where we left off in here. Stay tuned, guys.
All right, guys. This will make sense tomorrow when I finish this video, but I could not stand the thought of leaving these guys in these tubs tonight.
And it's like 1:40 in the morning.
Yeah, I finished that contest video up for you guys, and so I couldn't, like I said, stand the thought of these guys being in here all night. So we're going to go ahead and unbox them, and then we'll, like I said, it'll make sense tomorrow, but I wanted to at least bring y'all along for the unboxing of this guy and the Goliath over there. So.
Yeah. They're too big to stay in here overnight. It just
first
doesn't
off,
seem fair.
I'm going to get all this tape out of the way.
Yeah, and if you're familiar with the Columbia shows, if you're not, they always have the red tape around all the venomous stuff. That's just like how it's always been.
I'm going to save this for a memento, guys, to that shall I never become complacent
or careless
nor uncomfortable.
No worries.
Always should
I will
be
join your conscience for that.
Always going to stay uncomfortable.
Yeah.
It's a different ball game, guys, and I respect it. And we'll get into all that in the other part of the video.
It is, but we have done quite extensive research on this guy.
Yeah, we'll get into that
so,
in the morning.
But you know, we are feeling pretty confident about having him.
His enclosure.
Although we still don't want to trade it in bit.
They've already seen the enclosure. What I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to loosen this lid and set him. And I'm just going to loosen on the sides where his head is not we're going to set him in once I get it good and loose. And this is the most unnerving
thing. Part of it. Right.
I got that lid cracked, so we're going to go ahead and grab this little hook. Actually, we're going to close this door. We're going to go from this side, guys.
Yeah, probably a better...
Furthest distance that I can get. And somebody's out there laughing at me right now, saying, hey, you're with us and all. But guys, this is nothing to play with. And I don't want you guys going out there and... you know, thinking, oh, that reptile junkie guy's got one, so it's just a cool thing you gotta have. And guys, I fixed me 35 years old. It took me a long time. This is one thing I said I never would own, but after a lot of research, this is like the only indigenous snake to Georgia that I would care to own. I can't own any non-venomous snakes here, so this is the next best thing. Now guys, what I'm going to do from this point, I'm going to leave him be in that tub. I just wanted to get him in his enclosure. I'm going to add a little bit of water in there to it. But I'll let him come out on his own tonight. And here, I'll take the GoPro.
Yeah, I think the other camera will be pretty good for taking some good clips of this.
I'll definitely get some shots of that too with the other, but... guys, there he is, my dusky pygmy rattlesnake. Now let's move over here.
This is a tarantula.
I got that lock in the back pocket. Got a nice little lock. You probably already saw that in the beginning of the video. It's going to be weird putting this together. All right, now something not as nerve-wracking. That was...
I think you probably are less scared of that snake than you are of this spider.
I'm terrified. We're going to do the same thing, though. I'm
gonna
pop.
This is crazy.
I'm going to pop this lid, guys, first.
It's really crazy. But I just want them to be able to see in reference to your hand. Ooh, yes. Did you see that?
Yeah, his butt's ball. He's been in his container.
Oh, not
gonna,
happy.
You're going to have something bigger at some point, too.
Oh, yeah. Stay away from that. Trey has really bad allergies to stuff.
Yeah.
He really does.
We'll try this same approach with this guy. There again, somebody out there laughing at me.
My God, no.
I try to respect these animals.
That's crazy.
I try to respect these animals and give them their space and kind of let them do what they want to do, and I'm going to do the same with him for tonight. I'm going to add some water to his water bowl, just like with the pygmy.
Yeah, there's no sense in stressing these guys anymore. They've traveled a long way.
Yeah, they have. And I'll get y'all some more shots as they're settling in. I'm going to grab the other camera, and I'll throw them in here somewhere.
And yes, I have seen a tarantula flick hairs before. It's just never one this big. It's insane.
Yeah,
okay. I don't want her to kick any more hairs out. She's already bald.
Yeah.
Just, you know, it's a lot of stress for these guys, I'm sure, with the traveling and, you know, we're just glad to get them back. And that's why we could not leave these guys in a cup any longer.
Well, the little tarantula is going to stay in a cup tonight.
Yeah, but that's precisely why, is because the cup is probably about the size of what it really needs to be in right now anyway.
Yeah.
So it has no need to go anywhere. The blue tongue, we're going to get it set up. But
awesome.
I love the blue tongue.
One more time.
It's awesome. We'll talk about that more.
Yeah.
Also.
More in the video.
Yep.
There he is. One more time, guys. I'm really pumped.
Hey. Check it out.
Oh, he's coming out.
Sorry. Yeah.
No, you're good.
That's awesome.
I'm glad it looks.
Incredible. I swear that is like the coolest spider ever.
Man, he is so
big. To be able to see the hair flicking was just craziness.
Yeah, looking at it on big scale is really something else.
It is. It's totally different. I mean, we have a lot of spiders, but this is just crazy. I can see why they cost so much now.
Yeah.
Definitely worth the money. Just incredible. Even the spider.
We have to get some more light on the subject. Wow. There it comes down the glass. Yeah. Probably she happy is. To be out of that dang cup.
Well, that's what I said. I could tell. She, I don't think we really know, but... Either way, you could tell. I mean, it's like putting a giant rat in a cup. It's huge.
Yeah, guys, I know I don't sound that enthusiastic tonight. Like I said, it's after 1 in the morning, and it's been a long day. I am pumped, though. These are two of my dream species from...
Can't wait until all that hair comes back. It's just going to be a beautiful, beautiful spider.
Yes, it is.
Very exciting stuff.
I'm sure
and the
she's
blue
thirsty,
tongue
so.
Was epic also, so.
I'm going to go ahead and get the mister. I had some water in here warming up.
Probably at least one, maybe two things we didn't expect.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Really cool.
So crazy.
Let me get some more shots and throw them somewhere. That's
sorry,
one big
spider. I know we're filming this like a long time, but...
Yeah, it's about 8 minutes.
Not focused
and...
on the spider.
Yeah, the spider was coming out. Snake's just kind of sitting chilling like I figured he would. And guys, we'll pick it back up in the morning. See you shortly. All right, guys, I sure hope y'all enjoyed that section, that unboxing, and it makes sense now, because it sure didn't make sense to me last night, but anyway, here's the blue tongue. Before we get into that, one more thing I wanted to mention about the contest. Three special guys, which I say special because they're special to us, Sal Lopez 3, and you know, I've shouted him out a bunch. Mr.
That's
Dusty Jones
awesome.
And Mr. Chuck Horn. Now these guys, they
our
bowed out
Jones.
Of the contest because you know they said they wanted a prize to go to somebody else, and that was really cool. Sal, he gave us our first ever shout out when we started YouTube, so he goes back a long ways.
We had like 100 subscribers. It was,
yeah, it
really
was really
a cool,
cool
thing. He
really
had
humbling.
No reason to really yeah. No interaction there. He just I think enjoyed the video that he watched, and it was really cool. You know, that was really neat for us at 100 subs to hear Sal shout us out.
It really was, guys, and it was really humbling, and I'll never forget that.
And we've made long-term friends with him ever since.
Chuck sent me a spiny-tailed iguana, which is in here, and he also sent me my Cuban Nightingale, which is in here, a captive bred baby.
Which are MIA at the moment,
yeah.
But they're doing incredible.
They're doing incredible. And, you know, guys, you three guys, I'm gonna hook you up with something nice. I'll get in touch with you later on, though, but I just wanted to let y'all know I appreciate y'all and everything you've done to help me along the way with my channel.
And thanks again for the t-shirts, Reptile Jones.
Sure enough, man. And
Very cool stuff.
I hope I've been able to give back a small part of that. And I just, once again, I appreciate you guys. But back to the unboxing. And of course, guys, he's not living in his tub. Cameron's room is a disaster right now.
Yes.
I'm moving the dragon out of his enclosure. And this guy, we got a 40-gallon breeder for the dragon since he's grown. This guy's going to go in the dragon's enclosure for now. It'll be plenty of size until he grows some more. But...
Yeah, don't lie. You're going to keep him in this little tiny tub forever.
Yeah, right. This is a
you know better.
Meraki blue tongue, Papua New Guinea area.
And this is really kind of, I mean, we've had other skinks, but they haven't been this type of skink.
Yeah. And
so this is kind of our first go round with the blue tongue.
That's right.
You know, we're excited about this.
Now, a lot of people ask about, you know, if we're ever going to get a skink, and so there it is, Texas Cameron.
Incredible. I'm so excited about this guy.
When it's full grown, guys, it's going to need a 40-gallon breeder, larger, basking area, 90 to 95 degrees, and then, you know, 70 to 80 degrees on the cool end or the ambient side. And
I actually think this is my new favorite.
40 to 80% humidity. Now, one thing, well, you can tell, which we
we had to look it up ourselves too, which also Mini ZooTube actually threw it up there,
and that was really helpful. Thanks,
it,
guys.
It really was, because there's differences in these guys, from Indonesians to Australians.
And one, some of them are hard to tell the difference between.
One comes from the rainforest, one comes from the desert regions. As you can see, that lateral, well, that stripe going down his back, and he's also got some spots spotting on the front feet. So, from what we understand, if anybody out there, you know, wants to correct us if we're wrong, but. This should be a Meraki
blue tongue. And also, some of you
guys
have blue tongues that are on our subscribers list. Feel free to kind of give us some tips this go around. This is new for us. If you know anything that you think is helpful, let us know in the comments. That would be great.
Now, guys,
so far we're kind of sold on this guy.
Really cool.
Very neat.
Off to the next. Over here, and I got y'all some other clips of this guy. It's our Goliath bird eater. Peace Sturmey, supposed to be the largest spider in the world, but second with leg span, I think it was the Huntsman. He's somewhere MIA over yonder. He is in a 10-gallon for right now, the deep soil layer here, about 4 to 6 inches.
Yeah, if you can actually see. But I think we have gotten some really good clips otherwise. We picked that cork bark just because we thought that it would make a nice home, right?
Not sure if it's a male or a female. Females, of course, live longer. So I guess once it molts or I can get a better look at it, we'll try to decipher that one. These guys, they come from Central, Northern, South America, just all over South America. 78 to 85 degrees, 75 to 80% humidity. So... with that being said, I'm going to cover the top of this tank a little bit more, maybe add some more sphagnum moss, spangum moss, however you want to say it.
And if you notice the bedding, they really like to dig.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, about 4 to 6 inches on that guy.
Okay.
So once she settles in some more.
Yeah, maybe we'll get to see some digging.
Now sitting above it, guys, and I got you some other clips I'm going to throw in here of it as well. That is a Venezuelan sun tiger. That was a good eye on April.
Let's see if they can actually see it.
Well, I got some zooming
clips
I'll throw in there.
Probably more so on the other camera.
But they come from Brazil also, Guyana, 70 to 80%. I said Guyana. Guyana.
on the humidity. This was a really cool find, though, to me, anyway.
70-ish to 84 degrees, max of 84. It's an arboreal. There again,
beautiful.
Females live longer than males. We won't know yet. Beautiful spider. She got an awesome deal on that thing for $25. And I think the guy himself, he was kind of like, oh, $25? I thought it was...
Well, he tried to charge us $35, but the cup said $25, so that's what we left with for $25.
Of course, the other thing, guys, and he actually eat already, which was awesome, and I got you some feeding clips for it in. That is my first and going to be my only, unless I maybe get another one to go with it.
I seriously doubt that. We're already looking at, like, the sidewinders and stuff.
Whatever.
it's going to be a long time, though.
This is my dusky pygmy rattlesnake, guys. Now, I cannot own, as I said in the unboxing video, any non-venomous snakes that are indigenous to Georgia. And I can't own any turtles that live here. There's a whole bunch of crazy laws. There's a couple things I can have, but venomous snakes, no problem. So this is my snake that's indigenous to Georgia.
But you know what's crazy is we cannot own a corn snake, which we love so much. But we can own this guy. It's crazy how the laws work.
78 to 90 degree range, basking, you know, 80 to 90 degrees. So I'm going to add if y'all saw when I was doing the unboxing, there's a little window piece down at the bottom of this tank.
I think he's still hungry.
And I'm going to add a little heat mat that I can cycle on and off with I'm going to put a probe in here and such for him. But so far he's done great, guys. As I said, I'm going to throw a feeding clip in at the end. I might throw a couple little clips in here.
Look at
him eating.
You see his little rattle. Dinky rattle. I know that they can see that. I know nobody can hear that. But it was funny.
Crazy fact about these guys, nobody has died, which doesn't make it any less potent of a little snake. Still packs a punch.
More people are bitten by the snake than any other, especially in Florida. Reason being, most kids will pick it up because it looks so pretty, end up getting bit.
And it doesn't look like a threat to a child, so that's a big deal. You know, educate your kids on venomous snakes, for one.
Definitely. And guys, like I said in that other video, I'm fixing to turn 35 years old, and it took me a long time. Definitely not going to get complacent with this guy. It's not something to play with by any shape, form, or fashion. Done a lot of soul searching, guys. Me and April both looked at a lot of things.
I was totally against any venomous, period.
And I've said that in other videos. Early on, I was asked, we'd done the snake tag challenge video we did, and I was asked about that, you know, do you own any venomous or will you? And I said, no, because it'll, you know, you get bit, you're probably bankrupt.
But he makes a really good point. That centipede there,
yeah, it could,
I mean, that's really worse.
It's
almost
a hospital trip. Either one.
I mean, I don't know
trip.
Which one's worse, and we already had it. So, after doing the research, you know, and seeing what they're really about, what they're capable of, it doesn't make me feel as uncomfortable, I have to say.
Yeah, and he's locked, guys, not getting out of there.
And that was mandatory.
This, you know, this will not, none of these will move, not even a fraction. I mean,
and we don't
nothing.
Have that on the centipede. Maybe we should.
Yeah, might.
Because I don't know which would be worse.
But I am tickled. You know, I've always been fascinated with rattlesnakes and copperheads and cottonmouths, just like everybody else, guys. And I've just never.
Well, that's another
you know,
thing,
until
too.
Now,
people fuss about the kids. Oh, you have children. Well, for one, no kids are going to come in this room ever without us.
Without somebody here.
Not because they're venomous, just because it's children. You know, let them out. They could get harmed themselves, whether they're venomous or not. Not the kids, the animals. So it's kind of on the flip now. We have to worry about the kids getting hurt rather than animals. But not really, because there's a lock with a key, they can't get to it, but it's mainly for the animal safety. We do not let the kids come out here
super long
by themselves.
Tongs, guys. You already saw me. I put that, which you are going to see that clip of him eating the rat pup, but the guy told me I got him from, it's a captive born snake. He's been eating on rat pups, and I give him one, and he popped it. Took it, no problem. A couple other things we picked up from the show.
Very cool.
And I've got, God, guys, I think I've got 100 and some odd clips from the show that I've got to go through.
Tons of stuff.
Put all that together. It's going to probably be a long Repticon video. Hope y'all enjoy it.
And we have like 5 days before we get to do this again.
We're going to the Greenville show.
Which is epic.
April's 13th wedding anniversary is coming up.
No.
What?
12th anniversary. We've been together 13 years.
12th anniversary. Been together.
I'll forgive him because it has been 13 years
but,
either direction.
So we're going to go to Greenville, South Carolina. They got another Repticon. We're going to go goof off there and just spend the weekend.
Have some fun.
We had the kids with us this show. Not that they hamper us, we want to say, but
they get tired easy.
After about 45 minutes, you're pretty much dragging them along. About an hour is about, and they would give out. And, so me and April really kind of felt rushed through the show, so we're going to hit Greenville show just so
we
can kind of
just enjoy being there, looking at everything, having a good time.
And our kids, you know, we said, hey, kids, y'all want to go eat somewhere after the show, you know,
nope.
Wherever y'all want to go. And they were like, let's just go through McDonald's through the drive-thru.
And we do that all the time, but,
so,
you know, special occasion.
We're going to get something good to
decent
eat.
Decent food.
Going to have a nice sit-down meal and just enjoy it. So look forward to that. I'll get you some footage. I picked up some calcium without D3. Interesting thing.
That's controversial.
It is a controversial thing with leaving the bowl of calcium powder in with your leopard geckos. I've seen a lot of people discussing on boards and stuff about using it without the D3.
For a leave-in.
Yeah, for a leave-in. But still dusting, of course, crickets
with the
D3. One, you've got just a green, and one, you got a blue. There you go.
But we have plenty of people say that they've never used it.
Yeah, one guy at the show said he's
20 years.
Never had a problem breeding them 20 years, so it's controversial. But, you know, I try to.
If it can help, it Can't hurt.
Can't hurt. Picked up some hornworms.
Just a little colony of them. We're going to
let these grow a little. The frilled definitely
loves those. So we got those, a couple of little Pinellas County reptile tanks. There's
you guys are always asking where these tanks come from.
Picked up another little one. We're going to transfer the olive that we have into this enclosure and do some swapping around.
Yeah, we've got to switch around because the new one...
You're going to go in the boreal enclosure.
Yeah, this one's going to need a tall tank, so we'll kind of see how we switch things up from here.
And we got a couple of food bowls and some nice hides and such out there for Cameron's blue tongue.
Can't wait to get it
Cameron
set up.
Cameron and April's blue tongue, which, guys...
No, it's Cameron's.
I got a feeling that... We're going to this show this weekend. I'm going to get beat up pretty hard for another blue tongue. She is between the two of them.
I don't know. I'm going to see how much Cameron will share first for this week. And if he doesn't share, then yes, I need another blue tongue. My favorite. We have so much stuff, guys, and you're always asking for a hold me.
That's your hold me.
He is incredible, or she. Blueberry.
Yeah, I know my stance.
That's his name.
I don't hold a lot of animals. If they don't like to be held, I don't press the issue.
And I respect that.
Seems to enjoy it, so.
Completely.
I got dogs and cats to pet. I don't have any stuff in this room that cares for me to come out here and pet. So.
Well, the blue tongue doesn't mind being petted, so that's why we're enjoying him so much.
That's right. Guys. That's it. I know it's probably a long video between everything. Once we get it all thrown together, it'll probably be tomorrow for uploads, and then I'll be working tomorrow throughout the week. I got a coyote hunting video to put out for y'all.
All we didn't kill any
coyotes, one people zero, but I got some pretty good footage.
It was good there.
And of course, the rest of the Repticon part two coming out behind this one.
And then the weekend with another Repticon.
Oh, y'all get sick of seeing this ugly mug here before long, guys. I'm telling you. But, as always, I'll strive to bring you the best possible crap that I can. And thanks for watching. Continue support. I guess we'll catch you next time. Thanks, guys. Get down to the B side.